Hello and welcome to Microsoft Mechanics Live. Coming up, we're going to take a look at SharePoint Communication Sites, a brand new way for you to publish your content and reach a broad audience and further power your organization's intranet. We're going to show you how you can, in under 10 minutes, create a fast and beautiful intranet communication site that works across devices, use our out-of-box site design tools to quickly get started, and incorporate your own look and feel. You'll be able to author pages that use SharePoint web parts to add rich capabilities and pull in data from other services, even third parties, and interact with readers, get usage information, and see how your sites and your content are doing. And to do this, I'm joined by Dave Cohen from the SharePoint engineering team. Give him a warm welcome.
Thanks, Jeremy. Great to be here.
All right, so communication sites, they're a brand new way to publish content to a broader audience, but what problems are we solving for with communication sites?
Well, we built communication sites to make it easy to build a fast and beautiful mobile-ready intranet site to share your finished content and messages and to reach and interact with people across your organization. We're seeing many of you build these sites for events, campaigns, product launches, for teams to share their insights and expertise on topics, and many other scenarios where the key component is to communicate your message broadly and effectively.
All right, and you say it's fast, but we're going to put this to the test. We're going to challenge you. We're going to give you precisely 10 minutes to be able to build out a communication site. Now, we're going to let you do a couple of things. So redundant items, you know, I don't want to watch you load an image six times individually or, you know, load in documents every time and have to see that. So we're going to give you a couple of leeway there. I know you've got some stuff kind of pre-prepared, some documents. So let's put 10 minutes on the clock. Are you ready to start with this?
I'm ready.
All right. Your time starts right now.
All right. Well, I'm going to start from the SharePoint home, and I just click this Create Site button, and I'm given two options, a team site or a communication site. This site is going to be a resource for my entire company, and so I'm going to choose communication site. Here, I can see different site designs that we've pre-provisioned for you, and
So these are templates, and you've got a couple of different options that you can use, but you're running out of time, Dave.
I am, sorry. The the topic site here is a great site design for information-dense sites. We have other site designs like the showcase design. That's great for when you have beautiful images, lots of text, but it's a fairly static design. I'm short on time today, and so I absolutely want to start with one of our pre-canned designs. So I'm just going to give my site a name, Toso.
It's so easy. He's not even like urgently. He's still cool up here. He doesn't even care.
That's true. Now, of course, I run into a demo bug.
Uh-oh. Demo bug.
Yeah, my taskbar.
Oh.
How do I hide the taskbar?
What are you trying to do?
Hide the taskbar.
Oh, don't worry about hiding the taskbar. It's okay.
I need to get to a button behind.
Oh, you need to get to a button behind the taskbar. All right. Let's try to F11 and try that. Is it still being hit by the taskbar?
It is. Wow, we literally ran through this 10 minutes ago.
All right, let's not go full screen on that. Let's see if we can. Geez, these are some interesting things to work
on. All right, we're good.
All right.
I'm still good.
Now it's never gonna happen. At eight minutes and 15 seconds, can you still do it?
All right, so because I was a little rushed, I picked the wrong site design, but no worries, I can change that. So I'm just gonna quickly go in here. I really wanted the showcase, but like I said, the site design, I'm not locked into it. I can change it.
All right, hurry up.
So I'm gonna change it to layers. I'm gonna add three layers.
There we go.
No worries. I'm gonna leave news. I'm gonna delete this. And I'm gonna delete this. And I'm just gonna.
This is a real.
Yeah, race. This is.
I mean, you had like 3 seconds left in rehearsal, so we just lost a minute on troubleshooting taskbar issues.
Okay.
All right.
So the first thing I want to do now I've got the site set up back to where I want is I'm going to create a page to link my visitors to from the homepage of the site. So I'm going to save and close this.
All right. So sub pages now underneath the communication site.
I'm given a couple different page templates to choose from, and just like the site designs, I'm not locked in any. I can start with whichever I want. I'm going to pick single column. Okay.
Okay.
So now I'm going to name this page. It's going to be Program Overview.
Good name. Okay.
Now I want to update the title image. We know that people have some really great images that they they want to be on this site. I didn't get a chance to upload the images that I wanted to. I got a little flustered, so I'm just going to go into my overview folder, choose this, go. Luckily, I'm on a pretty fast demo network, I hope. Excellent. So what's great about the title region is not only can I drag this image around to where I want it to be, I can actually tell it where I want the browser to focus that image on in smaller screen resolution. So as it shrinks the size of the image, it's keeping what I tell it to in focus.
All right, now, 6 minutes, 30 seconds.
So now I already have the text of this page ready to go. I'm going to copy it. I'm going to paste it.
Okay, looks good. The formatting held.
Exactly.
Keep going.
Okay, I want to add an image. So now what I'm going to do is...
No pressure
whatsoever right now. Man, this music is intense. I'm just going to drag this image. I don't have time to play around with uploading it. Oh, boom. I just dragged an image
Look
into the
that.
Rich text editing
web part.
And it made an image web part. All right, but I'm not happy with this. I want the image and text to be side
by
side.
You got plenty of time.
So, yeah, thanks, Jeremy. So I'm going to go down, I'm going to open the toolbox, and I'm going to add a two-column section to my page. Go up.
Whoop. Oh, you forgot the L. You got to go back.
I did. I forgot the L. Back to the checkpoint. Who gets that? I'm going to cut that, add a rich text part, copy it in. All right, that's great, but now I want this image to be next to it. That's as easy as drag and drop. Boom.
There we go. Time check, 518.
All right. So next thing I want to do, I'm going to add a three-column section because I have a bunch of documents that I want my my site visitors to see. So add a file viewer part. I'm going to upload from my demo folder.
Nice. So this is going to take the PowerPoint and it's going to drop in a nice thumbnail view of it in a sec, but you got to keep going.
I do got to keep going.
You only got 4 minutes and 56 seconds.
Okay.
Time's running out.
I got this.
Don't you wish all the web devs that were building these sites for you on site were working like this with a 10-minute clock?
If you ever thought that we weren't committed to performance in SharePoint, let this convince you. All right, so.
This is risky. You're going to add Yammer to the site?
I am going to add Yammer. So Yammer is an important part of the conversations that happen across my company.
All right.
And I really want to bubble those up to my site. So I just drop a Yammer URL into this part.
There we go.
I'm going to choose top conversations because I want the most interesting conversations to come through to this site.
You got four minutes and 16 seconds.
That looks good. I'm going to publish this page.
All right, so you got all one right. page done in your
site.
So
now I could help people find this page, but I'm not ready to yet. I'm still building my site. So I'm going to go back to the home page, and I'm going to edit the hero web part.
Whoa,
that was incorrect. Go back. I'm going to edit the page and point this hero web part to the page that I just made. Now, awesome, it's right here in recent pages. It's saving me a ton of time. The next thing that I need to do is copy and paste all the text that I prepared because, oh man, am I running short on time.
You got 3 minutes and 37 seconds.
This is like when your manager says, hey, I need a site, and you didn't do it, and then he asks you where the site is. You can do it very quickly.
We saw We saw a really cool trick yesterday where you can use the RAND function from Excel and Word, and it'll just automatically generate paragraphs of content.
So we did say that I'm going to cheat a little bit. I'm just going to point. I'm just going to point the other tiles in this hero web part to some images. You saw how easy it is for me to create pages that I could actually link to. But for the sake of this demo, I'm just going to point them at images so my homepage looks good. I don't think my manager's really going to click through to those anyway.
All right. And the nice thing is, like any engineering, you can adjust scope based on the time that you have.
And you can see, I keep telling the hero web part to automatically pull in the images from the pages that I link to, and that's really saving me a lot of time right now. So, last one.
All right.
Upload it.
We've added
okay, how much
images.
Time
You're
do I have?
Down to 233.
All right, I got this.
You might not want to add the description. No, but you're going to go for it anyway. Look at that. He's brave.
I am brave or dumb, whichever. Okay.
All right. Beautiful.
So now, I had an image gallery part. I have a bunch of images here that I just want to go and quickly upload. My original intention had been to
preload them, but
preload them into the site assets right after I created the site.
You're gonna have to do some parallel processing.
But I got flustered, and so I'm just going.
Yeah, all right. Work on some other stuff while those guys load up.
All right. So last thing, I want to tell people who they can get in contact with today. I'm Andy. He's actually sitting in the audience today.
Okay.
I'm also gonna add Alyssa in this demo program. They're responsible for the.
You're gonna add Jeff Teeper, of course, right? No. I didn't mean to chew up your time.
No, because, you know, honestly, I don't want Jeff looking at this. Who knows?
Right,
he might click
right
through. My image gallery didn't load. That's okay. I got this.
He's got this. We've got another way. There's always more than one way to skin a cat.
There is.
Here we go.
One of the cool things that I can do is I can upload these images just directly to the site assets library. They should upload as long as the demo network doesn't go down. And as they upload, I'm going to tell this to just go and look at a document library, actually the site asset library.
We're at the last minute now.
Okay.
Oh, look at
the
images
coming in.
Popping in.
All right. Save and close. Okay. Now,
awesome.
I'm going for gold. I want to create a news post.
News post in 48 seconds. All right.
All right. So I already have my text. Actually, I need an image, so I'm going to upload an image quickly.
And he's not even going for the default ones. They're already there in the folder.
Nope.
He's going for it.
I have an image that I know I want.
Don't worry about refocusing that one. You got 28 seconds.
All right.
All right. This is the last thing he's doing, though. 21 seconds. I want you guys to count down when
publish.
You get to 10.
Okay, I'm back on my homepage. All I need to do, publish the homepage, share the site. It's open to my whole org. I'm gonna share it with.
8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Shared with everyone. You did it. And the SharePoint socks. Congratulations.
Thank you.
All right, but we're not done. We want to show some stuff now that it's all built, because we've got some more things to show, right? Because now that you've beat the time by 1 second, you've built your communication site. It looks beautiful. A page underneath it, a news post, all those things. But hey, you can do more. Now you've got a mobile site that's ready to go as well, right?
Yeah, that's right. So my boss is waiting for my site. He's on the go, and I'm just going to give it to him. I'm going to send him a link, and he can open it on his phone. So can we switch over to the phone?
There we go.
What do you guys think?
It's all mobile responsive. Everything's looking good in the portrait mode.
All right. It's got my news post. It's got the images. And it's got the people web part. Now, so my site's here. It's ready. I want to tell you about two more things. So something that we've added to communication sites and modern pages is the ability to interact with your readers and kind of get an idea of what they're doing on the site. So the first thing I want to show you is on the page that I created, that overview page, you can see at the bottom of the screen a little section there that says comment count. So now my readers can actually go and comment on my site. I can reply to them. And so it creates this interactivity that we never really had before. And then, cancel. Thank you.
There we go.
And then, can we switch back to desktop?
That's the last thing you need was the battery of the phone to die.
Yeah, thanks. That would have been fantastic.
Yes.
I have a charger right here, just in case. So as a site owner, the other thing I want to show you, I'm going to go to a different site because that's a brand new site. There's no usage on it, so I want to show you some actual data. On the site usage page, I can actually see in the last 7 days how many unique viewers went to my site, how many site visits I got, and I can actually see the pages and the documents that are trending the most. So we've really upped the level of interactivity between site owners and their readers and given them better analytics into how their sites are being used.
But you said there was two things. There's another thing you wanted to show, right?
Yeah. So lastly, we announced Hub Sites this week. And Hub Sites are a huge new feature. You can attach any site to a hub. And I'll actually show you what that looks like. I'm not going to demo attaching it to a hub today. I just wanted to bring up a hub that already existed. But you can see that the hub has a global navigation. It has its own branding. And that's basically how you can ensure that when you attach a site to a hub, that site gets the look and the feel of the hub, its global navigation, and then conversely, the activity from the sites that get attached to the hub flow back up in an aggregated way to the hub site itself.
So lots of really great updates for communication sites in SharePoint. You built an awesome site, Media Rich, in about 10 minutes. Everybody, what do you think of that? So if you're watching this, if people are watching this at home, where would I go to get started?
Well, communication sites are in production today, so the easiest thing is to just go to the SharePoint home in your organization, click Create Site, and get started. The SharePoint community is awesome, both online with events everywhere and happening all the time, so definitely check those out. And check out the resources at the link shown to get all the details of what you can do with SharePoint communication sites.
Awesome, Dave. Thank you again, and you beat the challenge. It must have been the Argyle socks. With SharePoint logos on them. Of course, you can keep watching Microsoft Mechanics for the latest updates in SharePoint and beyond across all of Microsoft. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.